Welcome to the BuildBlock ICF Installer Training Series.
Footings, foundations, and slabs. In this video, we'll help identify and understand the types of foundations that ICFs are built on. We'll discuss the advantages of each, as well as understand the basics of squaring an ICF project. Types of foundations. Before you select a foundation type to build your structure upon, BuildBlock highly recommends that you set up a consultation with a local structural engineer or contractors who are familiar with your region's soil load-bearing capacities. When it comes to an appropriate base for your ICF structure, there are several options. Footings are a type of shallow foundation which distribute loads from the structure directly to the ground beneath. Traditional foundations, or deep foundations, distribute weight-bearing loads deeper into the ground. Concrete piers are placed by drilling the approved diameter and depth of a hole into the ground on an approved spacing, inserting rebar, and filling with concrete. Pilings and piers are used when the building is either very heavy, such as a high-rise structure, or when the top layer of soil is very weak and loads need to be transferred to the stronger rock beneath. Grade beams can be used on top of pilings and piers when the surface soil's load-bearing capacity is less than the anticipated design load. These beams consist of reinforced concrete and transfer the load from a bearing wall into spaced foundations such as pile caps, caissons, or concrete piers. Poured grade beams can be used without pier pilings or caissons when the soil load-bearing capacity is greater than the anticipated design load. Lastly, slab-on-grade foundations are used when the concrete slab that is to be the foundation is formed and set directly on the ground. This slab may use post-tension or have thickened edges to support BuildBlock ICF forms. As you calculate the size of the foundation, you will need to follow prescriptive engineering practices based on wall heights, thicknesses, and soil compressive strengths. Also, check your local codes for size requirements. You can always overbuild, but you must meet minimum local requirements. Building codes exist to define and enforce minimum standards for construction. Educate yourself on all that apply to your project before beginning. Evaluate national, state, city, and county codes as well. Keep in mind that BuildBlock ICFs are an approved building method written into the International Residential Code, IRC, and International Building Code, IBC. If your specific plan exceeds the specifications found here or in the BuildBlock Engineering Manual, please consult a local engineer. Local codes will always dictate the final construction requirements. It is also important to understand that ICFs create an insulated solid mass wall as opposed to a cavity wall that uses bat or fill insulation. The specific insulation requirements for mass walls is different because of their superior performance. Comply with code requirements and best practices for insulating your project. Footings. When laying out your footings or stem walls, work with ICF-friendly dimensions if possible, and keep exterior finishes and flooring heights in mind. ICF-friendly dimensions take into account the length and height of BuildBlock ICF forms when designing your wall lengths. You'll also want to level footings within a quarter inch or less. After stacking the first two courses, shim and trim to level your footings. Be mindful of the fact that blocks will settle slightly when filled with concrete and rebar, and leveling footings from the beginning will equal fewer headaches for the rest of the project. Rebar reinforcement. Rebar is used to reinforce both the footings and foundations, as well as ICF walls. Vertical rebar will be placed and extend from your foundation footings or stem walls and then into the walls themselves. This vertical rebar will overlap to create continuous vertical reinforcement. Make sure your rebar dowels or pins exceed code requirements for wind load and backfill heights. Ensure that rebar is correctly set in the footing and extends properly above the footings for non-contact laps in walls. Rebar inside concrete must be 3 inches away from any soil exposure. Rebar must be 3/4 of an inch from the inside face of the foam blocks as well. And rebar must be 1 1/2 inches from any other faces such as bucking. This prevents moisture from intruding into the concrete and decaying the rebar. it will also provide sufficient concrete coverage for structural integrity. Squaring and chalking. Square your project before staging materials. When squaring, be sure to verify that the diagonal dimensions are equal. Detailed information about squaring your project is available in the BuildBlock installation and technical manual. Lastly, place chalk lines on the footings, marking the location of the outside edge of the block. Remember that the outside face of the block will be the outside face of the structure. If construction plans were not drawn for ICF, verify ICF form placement and center lines. In conclusion, the foundation of your ICF build is the base in which your entire project rests. Therefore, great care and consideration should go into each step of its creation. Building a solid foundation that is level, meeting or exceeding building codes, and reinforced appropriately will prevent costly setbacks in the building process and ultimately make the finished project strong and resilient.
Thank you for watching this video in the BuildBlock ICF Installer Training Series. For more information and other videos in this series, please visit our website at buildblock.com/training or our YouTube channel at youtube.com/buildblock.